Paramahamsa Nityananda, a compelling spiritual force of our millennium, founder of an international socio-spiritual movement, pioneer of a modern Vedic Renaissance. Born in the sacred town of Tiruvannamalai, a yogi by birth, fearless spiritual explorer, beacon of divine power, Paramahamsa Nityananda is today an inspiration for millions on the path. Adept in ancient mystical yogic sciences, researcher of the science of spirituality, guru for enlightenment. Every year, Paramahamsa Nityananda shares with over 1 crore people worldwide the treasures of his wisdom, the joy of his laughter, and the incomparable power of his initiation. Now, Paramahamsa Nityananda reveals the deeper secrets of life, science of life. Join us every day for an unforgettable spiritual experience.
I'll tell you, try to maintain the book of the heart externally first. Maybe you can maintain in a notebook by writing, or you can maintain in your computer or laptop or in your cell phone or BlackBerry by typing. But maintain book of the heart outside. Whatever clicks with you, what you hear from the external master and what you heard from external master, when it gets churned inside, what you click with internal master. As I said, if you get one click with from external master and if it goes on getting churned inside, you will have at least 100 click from internal master. Then even the one you got is forgotten. Forget about making more clicks inside. I tell you, enlightenment itself is nothing but getting subtle and subtle and subtle clicks, that's all. First 10,000 clicks you get about enlightenment will not work on you. It will only hit the grass plane of you. I can give you very clearly numbers of enlightenment. Decide first 10,000 click which you get from the master external. When I say master, not only from my form, even the book you read, my books you read or my discourses you listen, in any way you get from the external guru. First 10,000 clicks will not function on you. It is like a rain on the buffalo. Skin is too thick. So make this as a decision. At least 10,000 click which you get directly from me. Don't copy from somebody else's book. Your eyes or your ears should have picked it up. 10,000 click. Go on pinning down, pinning down, pinning down. It will not touch you immediately. Then after 10,000, whatever clicks, by the time you would have achieved certain sensitivity, certain sense of subtlety, in that subtlety, whatever click hits, that only becomes satori or samadhi. For 10,000 hours, if the rain falls on the buffalo, only then the skin will give little way and that buffalo will feel little cold, it will start sneezing. Try to maintain book of heart. You can maintain in your cell phone, nothing wrong. But don't keep in the form of hints. No, you will forget. Keep a full, complete sentence. For example, I am giving the instruction, this, maintain book of heart. Don't try to have a book of heart. No. Maintain the book of heart. Full sentence. Which makes meaning for you completely. Whenever you read again, keep the book of heart. I used to keep. It was a hard work in the initial level. Whatever I hear from Annamalai Swami, I will write in my own hand. This idea of book of heart was imparted on me, given to me by Annamalai Swami. Annamalai Swamigal's book of heart is still with us. We have in our archives. I can say he appreciated. I think I started writing even before I met him, in a very casual way. But he appreciated and gave me the clarity. That is a spiritual practice. What I was doing without even knowing it as a spiritual practice. Whatever click I get from the external master. So I had many teachers. Ram Surat Kumar. Ram Surat Kumar will rarely speak, but I have heard many words when he spoke to other disciples. When people come to him, he will say few words. Those words will be very sharp. Sharp click. Raghupati Yogi, Kuppammal, Annamalai Swami himself, so many people, whatever I used to hear, everything I'll come back and sit and pen down. I'm feeling so bad that 11, 12 books I got lost because every day whatever Arunagiri Yogeshwara spoke, I've written. I'm praying that we should get that books back because that books will be a solid evidence. I had Arunagiri Yogeshwara's darshan and my whole relationship with Arunagiri Yogeshwara is beautifully described in that, how I felt with him. So the words which he gives, based on that itself, when I come back and write, from that itself you can see the relationship getting matured. We have one of my diary we have retrieved. In that we have a description of my relationship with one Siddha who lived in Thiruvannamalai, who did not move out of this small 3 feet by 3 feet. He always sat only in that place. He is called Adimudi Chittar. He had the darshan of Arunachaleshwara. Still his samadhi is there next to our ashram. My relationship with him is very clearly, very nicely described. My experiences with him is described in the diary which we got, one diary, some 3-4 days of recording. Anyhow, whatever I heard from Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I'll pen down. And whatever I read clicked with me, I'll pen down. When I am writing every day, thinking, writing all these ideas, so many will click with me internally, that internal guru's teachings. I'll pen down that also. In the initial level, you should be doing this, keeping the book of heart. For the external success, accounts is very important. For the internal success, enlightenment, book of the heart is very, very important. I am not saying you should read it every day. No. Just maintain it. You will see how your concepts about you, society, God, world, everything is getting matured. Your ideas will grow matured. Otherwise, sometime, just by immature ideas, you waste your whole life. You will see how your ideas are getting matured. If you know how your ideas are getting matured, you will understand you are really growing. You will have so much of confidence. You are really growing. Only when you have the book of heart, you will get the habit of constantly referring to it in your heart. See, only when you start penning down externally, you will slowly digest it, internalize it. That will become part of you. You will pen down. In the paper, externally, or type it. Then simply it will become part of you. Book of heart. When it becomes internal, that is what I call your scripture. Please understand. Each one has to write his scripture. My scripture cannot be useful completely for you. Your scripture cannot be useful completely for your disciples if you become enlightened. Even if you become enlightened, your scripture cannot be 100% useful for your disciple. I can say, my scripture can be useful for you, maybe 90%, because we are in same time zone, same period. But the last 10%, which is crucial, you only have to write for yourself. Same way for your disciple. If you become enlightened, for your disciple also, only 90% of your book of art will be useful for him. The remaining crucial 10%, he has to write. I don't know why these 10 volumes got lost, 10, 11 volumes, I don't know. Maybe it is too secret and too sacred, which cannot be revealed to a common man. It got lost. My personal intimate experiences with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, everything I have penned down, how I felt with him, how he reciprocated. I still remember, I went and read out whatever I wrote to him. He picked up that book and read. There were some spelling mistakes. He himself corrected it. His handwriting is there. What to do? It's unfortunate. Somewhere we lost it. And knowing this, next time onwards, I started making more spelling mistakes. Purposely, so that he will correct it with his own handwriting. And there is a signature of him in that book. We'll get it. I'm just consoling myself. Because that would have been such a great asset for all you guys. You see, I don't need that book now. Already that book has become my internal part, internal scripture. It has become book of art for me, but it can be a very big use for all of you.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.